This is how we break down the throat. These little drills are how you get better. There's nothing natural about this. You guys are gonna do a throw and we're gonna work on separation, okay? Stretch, reflex, and orbit, and the release. And what you're gonna see is a lot of you dipping and scooping. There's gonna be attempts to try to move your hips more than you should. Okay, so take your band, and what we're gonna do now is we're gonna be winding and feeling that separation, and we're conscious of the orbit. So we're here in Sydney. You can see, if you can kind of tell by the weather, we had a much cooler day. We came in, it was hot and muggy. We got a light rain and we kind of just started about, 15 minutes later, and it worked out great. The rain went away, we set everything up, and we had a really great productive day.
I think the kids got, especially the young kids, were really starting to connect it towards the end of the day.
Right.
And some of the drills, as we saw during the day, they went really well. Like the partner up with the heel, push with the hip.
Right.
It was really good. And one thing I took out of it was the tempo change. So that was a good experience. We had a bigger camp, so that was good.
My name's Peter Blake. I'm from Berrima. My daughters Ruby and Evie.
Okay.
Yeah, so at first it seemed like, you know, this drill and that drill, and I wasn't quite sure how that all fitted in, but then as it came together in the end, you could see how the specific movements were the key to getting the speed and the positions and everything right, just to get a nice smooth throw, I suppose.
Here's the big mistake. When I said to you guys, just wind up, and you guys all did this, you turned your hips and your shoulders. You see that? Now there's no separation.
The system's fantastic. I've just, the past 2.5, we're into our third season with it now. So the kids are improving so much, even the ones that started off when we introduced it to the beginners. And the beginners are slowly catching, and believe it or not, really fast, improving really quick because I'm getting better as a coach.
I think the detail was probably better. Like as a second time round participant, I think it was better.
Great.
I think the location was great too. It allowed everyone, a bit more room to spread out, as well in practice. But I think the drills were a lot better, I think.
Training with TT and I, we never did the drills.
Okay.
Now that I actually know the drills, that I can learn.
Okay, awesome. And how did the six pillars, that 2 seconds, you guys understand, what do you think of that? Did that help you understand the throw a lot better?
Breaks down the 2 seconds into 6 really easy bits to understand.
Awesome.
More drills?
Yeah. So you notice we put it together. How did we do it? We did some movement, then we did some throwing. Yeah, tell me the best part of the camp.
Enjoying it and having fun.
All right, well, that's good. Great to see the building from day 2. The kids kind of understanding the concepts more. Our format has changed quite a bit, even tweaked it up a lot for summer. Even just a couple weeks ago, we did a camp in Ohio and we started to play with it and we refined it. And by the time we did our Brisbane camp, which was our second camp, and here in Sydney, things have been running really smooth. It keeps the kids really engaged. We've got a lot of young kids here. So even for the teenage kid, how we've been structuring it, so just constant movement, it's really helping them to understand. We put it all together, and by the end of the day, it all makes sense. We've trained the patterns. So again, real thankful to the people here, great feedback.